Jangan langsung nanya. Dalam.
Ya, kenapa? Mulai ya. Hello and welcome to the Unindra News. My name is Galang and I will be accompanying you to 30 minutes forward. Our story today is about the story of the employment termination in Indonesia. That affect the people who has a job and end by pandemic. So the first question I will tell you, what the impact of this termination of employment for the Indonesian economy? Specifically, I want to ask to Kiki as a panelist.
Galang, can you repeat the question?
Okay, panelists, I want you ask, what is the impact of this termination of employment for the Indonesian economy specifically?
Okay,
can you answer my question?
Okay, I will answer your question. The what is the term on employment? The term is termination of employment refers to the end an employee works with a company. An employee may be terminated from a job of their own, free will or following a decision made by employer. Okay, maybe enough from my answer. Can you continue?
About... Oh, thank you for your answer, Kiki. So here, we have a victim from the employment termination initiative. Yes. We say hello to Rusfa and Della. Hello, Rusfa and Della.
Hello.
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 So, hello. I want to ask Rusfa first. How did you feel when you found out you were let off?
Okay, getting fired can be scary. It disrupts your life, your finances, and it can add stress at the time when you may already be dealing with stressors that may have contributed to why you're actually fired in the first place. Getting fired can be traumatic, but it can also stressors.
I know. Yeah, it's so difficult for your life, right?
Yes, many of us define ourselves to our career, our job. Let's face it, it is work full time. We spend more time in our job than sleeping or spending time with our family or any other activity. So it's only naturally to feel what we are, what we do. So it's easy to see how being fired can have such a devastating impact on ourselves. Ourselves, but being fired doesn't define you. Being fired can lead to bigger and better opportunities you may not have otherwise been open to or aware of. Thank you.
Okay, thank you for your answer. So, at the other seat, we have Ali as a panelist. Ali, can you ask my question, please? Can the company rehire employees who have been laid off if the pandemic is over?
Okay, thank you very much, Rusfa. Maybe I think in general companies can hire employees who have been laid off if the pandemic is over and companies just did for this year. The decision to rehire employees will depend on various factors, such as the company's financial situation, the availability of work, and the skills and qualifications of laid off employees. It is best to consult with the company's HR department or the council for specific information regarding retiring policy. That's my answer.
Thank you for the answer, Ali. You have a good answer for us. So I have a question for another victim of the employment termination of Indonesia. We say hello to Della. Hello, Della.
Hello.
Hello, Della. After you being laid off by your company, what do you do now, right now?
Mm, to be honest, the really makes me sad and disappointed, but I have to believe that this for the best.
Itu pertanyaan aku.
Apa?
Galak.
Okay, thank you Ali for your answer as your as the panelist in here. So I want to ask Rusfa again. After being let off, what do you know, Rusfa?
I start my business opportunity to sell food online shops, and that's very promising. Starting a business really needs attention and passion, but after a long time, it has paid off slowly but sure.
You have a good future, I think.
Yeah, we need attention and passion, but after a long time, I think it has paid off slowly but sure.
It's very productive for us now. We have a selling online shop and then selling a things in online shop. So we have to back to the Kiki as a panelist.
Yes.
It's the last question for you, Kiki.
Okay.
What should the government do if this pandemic ends and for the world, of course?
Maybe for the governments may need to step in due to insane market condition. Crisis condition can dramatically reduce the availability of private finance. Heightened economy uncertainly may push bank to be more selective in their investment decision or to charge unusually high margins to now risky borrower. This might starve firms of financing when it is needed most, especially that do not have enough cash on hand. Government intervention is essential to fill the gaps left by private financial. Maybe enough.
Okay, thank you for the answer, Kiki. You have a good answer. So, yes, you have another Ali. Answer, Ali?
Yes, you have yes. Another.
I have another answer. Maybe if the pandemic ends, the government should focus on managing policies and programs that will help workers who have been affected by the pandemic. This could include like providing financial assistance to workers who have lost their jobs or have had their power deleted due to the pandemic. And then offering jobs and education programs to help workers develop new skills and find new employment opportunities. And also encouraging businesses to rehire workers who were laid off during the pandemic. And implementing workplace safety measures to protect workers from future harm. And then providing mental health support to workers who have been infected by the pandemic. And the last is offering extra security and other financial support to businesses that hire workers who were affected by the pandemic. Overall, governments should prioritize the well-being of workers and provide support to help them recover from the economic impact of the pandemic. This is my last part.
That's it, Ali.
Yeah, it's enough.
Yeah, it's an excellent answer, I think. You have an excellent answer.
Thank you, Ali.
So it's the last question for the victim, for Della. Can you hear me?
Yes, of course.
So Della, if the pandemic is over, do you intend to return to your old company?
Galang, can you repeat the question?
Of course, Della. So I want to repeat your question. Repeat my question. So Della, what's in the company? What is the impact? Ulang. If the pandemic is over, do you intend to return to your old company, Della?
to be honest, this really makes me sad, and but I have to believe that this is for the best. I will be back because that's what I'm waiting for, because I'm one of those people who find it difficult to quickly blend into the company. So like that.
So that's it, Della?
It's enough.
Okay, thank you, Della. Thank you, Rusfa. Thank you, Kiki, and thank you, Ali.
Thank you.
Okay.
So
there is a real danger that crisis will increase poverty and within inequalities with impact felt for years to come. Countries now need to do everything they can to stop this jobs crisis from turning into a social crisis. Reconstructing better and more resilient labor market is an essential investment in the future and future generations. This page features the latest OECD work on the impact of COVID-19 on employment and jobs, along with OECD recommendation and policy advice, and how best to bridge to recovery phase. Thank you. In Indonesia, or to employee in Indonesia, is the emotional toll of being laid off can be devastating, especially for employees who have been with the company for an extended period and have built strong relationship with their co-workers. In addition to the emotional impact, layoffs can negatively impact an individual's sense of self-worth. Also, the impact of COVID-19 or pandemic on employee and jobs. The COVID-19 pandemic has triggered one of the worst job crisis since the Great Depression. The real is a real thing.
That's all the news today. Well, viewers, that's all the news today. If you have some critics and suggestions, please visit us, www.unindra.com, and for the, or you may call us at 021-567-8910. Finally, I'm an all crew of Unindra TV. Stay, have a wonderful day. See you next time, and bye-bye. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.